Good morning.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? It's nice to see you. Why don't you go ahead and grab a hot towel and some lubricant off of the table? Everyone's so excited to see you. Isn't that right, everyone?
Oh, yeah, right there. Oh,
there we go. Oh, look who just rolled up. It's Josh. Hannah, you found this. Sultry Hannah. It's about a couple that decided to change their relationship into an open relationship after 25 years together.
Wow. Look, I bet you a lot of people have thought about this.
Yep.
A lot.
And I bet the vast majority of them have, let's just let Clayne Crawford tell us about it and just let it stay inside. But this guy brings it up 25 years in, and they give it a go. There's a lot to talk about here.
Like you said, 25 years together, man and his wife made the decision to change things up with a quote-unquote open relationship. Apparently, a mutual friend offered an orgy experience with him and his partner. The group thing didn't appeal to them, but some one-on-one action did. But the guy wasn't prepared for the jealousy he felt when it was his wife's turn for fun. That's
selfish.
Where it always goes wrong.
Bastard. Little swapsies. That's what they did. So instead of just one big old, you know, crush pile on the floor, lay down a tarp and breathe through your mouth, they were like, okay, you in this room, you in this room. And I'm trying to unpack all this from the word go. All right. I've known people in relationships like this, and they're very happy. And so they have families and successful jobs.
What do you
jobs.
Mean like this? Like open?
Like open, but from what I know, and you know two of them. You know two of them. You know. Oh, I'll tell you off the air. I don't blow them up. But they started like this. They knew
right.
that world.
From jump,
and they were like, oh, you're, what do they call it, poly? You're poly, I'm poly. And they then got together in that world and both of them like, this
yes.
is what we're from, so this is how we will stay.
It seems to be the level of, you know, the percentage of the success rate is higher when you do it going in knowing that that's what's what.
Because just the thought
of bringing it up
is, that could be a headshot in and of itself. Not even doing it. I mean, Hannah, I turn to you, the woman in the room, that you got Tank, and I'm talking hypothetically, so do not go home and punch him in the balls, okay? This is hypotheticals. I'm sorry, Tank, but I need you at this moment. He just comes home, and it's like, hey, listen, we've been together for a couple years now. It slows down. It inevitably does. I got it. We were trying to, you know, role play a little bit. You know, I was
okay.
Schwarzenegger. You were DeVito.
Okay.
We tried to do a twins thing.
Right.
Didn't quite get that. You know, we brought in all the food. Remember the one time
Ooh,
we did the
okay.
food? I covered you in all that spiced ham.
See, you tried a bunch of things.
We tried a
I
bunch
like
of
this.
Stuff.
Good. I like the way you're selling it. Go, go.
But
keep going.
But what if we maybe added another couple?
Out the door.
Damn.
Really?
Done.
Bye.
He's out. Just the suggestion. Just the
How
suggestion.
How long have you been together?
Almost a year.
Okay. That's a little too soon. Okay, pretend you've been together for 10 years.
Well, no, this is 25.
25 years.
Imagine you've been together for 25.
It's hard to imagine.
Dust I know it is, but you just got to think. Maybe they're in a different headspace at that point. They're
yeah.
like, you know what?
There's cobwebs on my hoo-hoo, okay? My gazanctogazoid has got mothballs all around it. I might as well put it in storage. So maybe at this point, he's just like, nothing ventured, nothing gained. We haven't had sex in 2 years. Who cares? Maybe this will be something that'll get you to leave my ass.
Yeah, maybe, look, maybe they're not happy, and this would, I don't know, maybe make them happy. My other train of thought was, maybe instead of being unfaithful, you can be unfaithful, but do it out in the open.
Yeah, is it?
Instead of having to run around and cheat and, you know, do whatever that's called, be an adulterer, infidelity,
whatever.
At least now it's all on the table. You know what's happening.
Like, listen, I want this to happen.
Is that maybe a...
I feel the urge. It's coming on. I'm gonna, but I'm letting you know. I'm doing you, I hate to say the courtesy, but, like, listen, I'm getting restless. That bedroom has been a crypt for a long time. I don't want to leave you, but I got my needs.
But then we haven't even gotten to the point where he was all good with it, right?
Yeah, but then what happened?
And then when, you know, she's getting the bottom knocked out of it, he gets all jealous.
Yeah, exactly. So he goes in, gets some 45-minute little chihuahua or 45-second, like, over. And then out of nowhere, here comes Lesnar, just murder
pile drive.
My turn!
Noises you never heard before.
Yeah. Oh, you like that?
He's putting things in places you never dreamed of.
Wait a minute, that's not where that goes.
Honey, are you okay in there?
Yeah, fine.
We got a bleeder.
Yeah.
Honey, are you okay in there?
I've never been better, honey.
You guys almost done?
Nowhere near.
Game of Thrones is about to start.
Don't spoil it. He's currently dislocating all my limbs.
Make some popcorn. Can you walk? Can you walk?
Don't need to. He's going to carry me around from now on. I am his.
Open relationships. Reading an article about a guy who, after 25 years, turned to his wife and was like, hey, you want to open this thing up? Let's open this thing up.
What's up, bitch?
Let's open it up.
Let's go ahead and let's invite the neighbors over.
And apparently they had some people that were willing to help them open it up.
Oh, so sweet of them.
And
as a matter of fact, Tom, you're more than welcome to come by my way.
I guess it seemed to be going okay, but then, you know, the one word, jealousy.
Uh-huh.
Kind of seeps in.
He got to go first by the sounds of it.
He got his and he was fine. But then when she was, you know, getting snapped in half, he didn't like it.
Yeah, when Jason Momoa was in there just blasting the lining out of it. And meanwhile, he was done. And all the time it takes you to peel an orange. Yeah, it ain't going to go well.
Here it is. Never been in a poly relationship, but I was partnered with one for a time. I believe this is a woman. It's definitely not for everyone, but the guy's wife had a jealousy fetish.
Mm.
So she would want to hear about everything we did. They were super supportive and even helped me out financially when things got tough. There were different boundaries set in place. And as long as they were respected, everyone had a great time.
Wow. Some points are being made here. Angela says, I had a friend that brought a third person into the bedroom. Wife left the husband for that third person.
See?
Apparently he just gave it a little better than she was getting.
Poly only works if both people are 100% on board. If one is 99% on board, jealousy will seep in over time.
Yeah, I was on Facebook trying to find that one couple that I know you and I know from long, long times ago. And they are from that world prior to each other.
Oh, those people you were talking
those
about?
Those people.
Back in the day.
Got it. You know those two. Ooh, because yeah. They would just make offers to a Burger King drive-thru employee. Hey, thanks for my Whopper. You want to my wife? Like, okay, how about you be a little bit more selective?
Yeah, I saw a lot of nude pictures of that dude's wife.
Too many. But too many, as a matter of fact. Didn't even ask.
He was just like, hey, here, look at this.
Sir, I'm at a children's cancer benefit right now. I'm just trying to have myself some meatballs and taquitos. Please put your wife away.
My good friend's buddy and his wife are swingers. I have two things to say. One, as the story goes, when they first met my wife, his wife pulled mine aside and said, I know how this works, so I wanted to come to you first. Do we have them on the phone? Which one?
Whoa.
Where?
No name.
No name. We got no name? Okay.
Line three.
This is that person.
Is it a guy or girl?
It's a guy.
Guy. Okay. I'm going to call you Roy. All right. I'm just going to call you Roy, but we got Roy on line three. Swinging Roy. What's up?
Hey. Hey, guys.
Hey.
What's up?
Go
ahead.
Oh, sorry. It's my buddy's buddy. So him and his wife, they got married real young,
sure.
Kind of 18, 19, something like that. And I guess they just explored this this area. And they've been doing it ever since. They try to reach out to certain people, grab them in. But
they pulled your wife aside? They pulled your wife aside?
So he's told me before, not like asked me, but he's kind of always kind of said something about it.
He floats it out there. He goes, hey, you know, if you
casts
ever
a line,
if you ever, you know what we're into. And if you guys ever want to, you know, just let me know. Something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, but really the go-to was her going to my wife.
Yeah, that's how you do it. You send the lady. You send the lady to get the others.
Yeah, you get some creepo dude with cheese fingers trying to hit on the wife. You're going to have a brawl.
Yeah, you send the hot swinger wife out. She's got her boobs out. Both of the ladies have already had a bunch of Pinot Gris.
Oh, yeah.
They're all socially lubricated, and then she starts to hit on her. It didn't work, did it?
Nailed it. No, it did not work for us.
So you never did it?
Oh, no. They're too close of friends now to ever do that. But, yeah, they swung for the fences and whiffed like Chris Davis.
Now, does it change your relationship afterwards now that they made that attempt? Because it seems like we were saying earlier, just the offer, just the ask can forever change the course of a relationship.
Nope, not one bit.
Oh, really? Because I agree. Let me ask you, we've been around a few of these people, and they kind of have, like, this vibe about them.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to call it, like, a creepy vibe or whatever kind of vibe. You don't like, pick up on, like, some sort of vibe. They just seem like normal people to you?
Just really energetic, fun people.
They aren't usually extroverts. Okay. Like, the one couple we keep vaguely referring to, a hot, confident energy.
Yes.
It's 2 degrees warmer near them at all times.
It is. You're right.
Their space bubble is borderline non-existent. They're the type of person that will go in for the hug without asking.
Right. He's always at half mast.
He's always at all times. Always is pitching a tent.
Working with a semi.
Looks like he's got a sundial under his dockers. Who's been holding for a second? Let's talk to Kimmy in Baltimore. Kimmy, good morning. Thank you for calling.
Jamie,
my apologies. Jamie, good morning.
That's okay. Yeah, my partner and I are poly. We've been dating for almost 3 years. We've known each other for almost 4.
Where does jealousy factor in? None? You got 0?
It's always a thing because it's a human emotion. I feel like that it pops up in all different kinds of relationships throughout your life. And I'd be lying if I said that it wasn't a thing.
Okay.
But it has actually made our communication a lot better because we talk about it instead of, like, just burying it deep down and not addressing things.
You keep it out in the air so it doesn't fester and
resentment.
Then
like, yeah.
Bubble up on a work trip somewhere.
Let me ask you this. In terms of him and you, after you have been with another partner, what kind of agreement is there in terms of wanting to know details?
We just honestly kind of play it by ear. Sometimes we're in, like, a better mood to be able, like, yeah, sure, tell me about it. And sometimes we're not, like, and if we're not, we're pretty open with each other. Like, you know, we'll let each other know, I really want to hear about it right now. And we don't get offended by it because we know that it's just a thing that you might not want to hear at that point.
Were you two like this prior to meeting one another, or was this a mutual decision to be like this?
He wasn't. I was. We started dating, we decided to be poly from the beginning, and it's worked really well for us.
And where's his jealousy level at? Because it seems like the guys are more inclined to be the one that gets jealous.
It happens, but honestly, he's a lot better with jealousy than I am. Like, he's actually really good at it. Like, as far as talking about it, he's just better in general when it comes to communication than I am. I feel I'm pretty good at it. But
are you guys hot? Are you hot?
You sound very attractive.
Are you a hot couple?
I feel like I'm hot. He's
whoa! Watch out, language.
Damn, she's getting all. He's what? Wow. He's what?
Yeah, he's really hot.
How nice would it be to have someone get so steamed up about your appearance?
Drop an F-bomb.
God, Scott is just f***ing hot. Just so f***ing hot.
F-word came just flying out of her mouth. She was going to say he's so.
Oh yeah.
At blanking hot, and I had to dump you.
Hey, things are flying into it.
It's Josh Spiegel. Remember, there are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.